Welcome back. Simon Yates is, for better or for worse, known as the guy who cut the rope in the Andes. The true story that became that movie, Touching the Void. Nearly 25 years since then, Simon remains one of the world's greatest mountain climbers, and he's recounted some of his latest challenges in a great book called The Wild Within. And it's great to have you with us, Simon. Look, that tag is a dreadful tag, but I think so many people who can't go mountain climbing, who don't have that sort of drive in them, can relate to that moment where you're there with a mate and you make a decision to cut the rope on it.
Yeah.
That's why, you know, we identify you that way.
Exactly. And
it still must remain one of the toughest things that you've had in your life.
The lead up to it, I found tougher. The actual decision, you know, was not too bad. My problem there was I didn't know what to do. You know, I was struggling for a long period of time there to figure out sort of anything I could do. And it was only when I remembered I'd got a knife.
Just recap that situation for us.
Joe had broken his leg, and then I was lowering him down the mountain to try and get him off. And later on that day, in a storm, unknowingly, I lowered him off the edge of an ice cliff. And then this stalemate developed. I was being pulled from the cliff. He couldn't get back up. And I took a decision, as you say, to cut the rope. But my big problem was, what do I do? And it was only when I remembered I'd got a knife that the solution to the predicament that I was in presented itself, I suppose.
It's one of these things. You guys are made of different stuff because, I guess most of us won't have to face a challenge like this, but to cut the rope on a mate and knowing that you're killing him,
well, I suppose I didn't know I was killing him at the time. I probably thought that was the likely outcome, but as it turned out, we both lived, didn't we? So it was a... with hindsight, it was a smart decision.
It was.
It saved my life at that point in time, but ultimately saved both of our lives as well.
All right. Well, all's well that ends well, the old mountain climbing saying.
Yeah.
you're recounting some of your new experiences. You say in the preface to this new book that mountain climbers, after they've got some experience behind them, they tend to start to specialise either higher, steeper, or in regions, and you say you've gone remoter. You're looking for the most unclimbed places in the world.
Yeah, untrodden places. I've been increasingly drawn to them. I don't know, maybe I'm getting antisocial in my old age or something like that, but I just really like places that have a feeling that nobody's ever been here, basically.
What's the attraction about that?
Well, it's the same challenge as all mountains. You know, it's a mental and physical challenge in an extreme environment. And what I get out of it big time is I feel I'm reconnecting with the natural world in an environment like that, a world that's distanced from us now as we sit in front of our computers, you know. So that's what, and I get more of a feeling from that in remote places than places where there are a lot of other people and a lot of other people have trod.
You see some amazing things, don't you? It's worth the effort.
And I've been lucky to witness some incredible parts of the world, basically.
Has it become harder since you've become a dad? Do you feel the risks a little bit more sharply?
To a certain extent, but also, with the children, they're always there. You know, I'm always thinking about them. They're always in my mind. So, but this is what I do. You know, I was sort of late coming to fatherhood. My pastime is also my job, so this is my life now, basically.
All right. What's the next challenge?
I'll be in the Pamirs in Tajikistan in a few weeks' time, so...
Tajikistan?
Yeah.
It sounds pretty remote.
It's north of Afghanistan, it's nice part of the world.
All right, mate. Make sure you take some photos and let the rest of us climb along with you.
Thank you very much.
Cheers, Simon.
Yeah.
Great book, Layla.